Hi, this is Dr. Asa Oxner from the Division of General Internal Medicine in the Department of Internal Medicine at the University of South Florida. And today we are going to continue our HIV Update Series. This is part 2 of 7. We're going to talk about outpatient screening guidelines today for HIV. So HIV testing is accomplished with an ELISA test, and if that is positive on initial, then the lab will automatically confirm that test with a Western blot. Results are confidential. However, a positive result is reportable to the health department by law, and the physician and lab are both responsible for reporting to the health department, but not allowed to share the result with any other parties, and so that's why it's confidential. Prior to getting a test, the law requires us to get verbal informed consent from a patient, and that should be documented in the chart that there was a discussion. However, the new updates on all of the guidelines no longer require written signed consent from the patient in order to order an HIV test. So that's a new change. So there's many available tests for HIV. The HIV antibody screen is the first one, the ELISA, and that's going to be your initial screening test. That's confirmed with a Western blot if it's positive. Then, in addition to those, if you have positive results on those, you're also going to then send the CD4 count and the HIV RNA, which is called the viral load. And both of those tests are going to help you understand what stage of disease the patient is in upon initial diagnosis. Also, part of the newer guidelines indicate that there's up to a 15% resistance in initial diagnoses of HIV. So the virus that is transmitted already has resistance to some of the drugs in up to 15% of patients. And so nowadays, in the developed world, we also order an HIV genotype right up front upon initial diagnosis. The other three tests over here, the phenotype, the HLA-B5701, and the trophile assay, those are all more specialized tests that you do not order upon initial diagnosis, but you would order them when you're thinking about some of the specific medications. So tune in later to other podcasts for more updates on those. One of the most popular ways to test for HIV these days is with some of the rapid HIV tests. And the one that's available in many of the clinics that we practice at USF, including the Morsani Clinic, the Bridge Clinic, and USF South, is the OraQuick Advance. And so this is a really great test because it only takes 20 minutes for the patients to get their results. And it's non-invasive. It's actually just a cheek swab. It works pretty much the same way as a pregnancy test. You can see that there's two little markers, and that's where the lines would be. And so two lines is a positive and one line is a negative. So it's very user-friendly. The sensitivity and specificity are very high still, just as good as the traditional ELISAs that we sent to the lab. And the results come back in 20 minutes, so it's more convenient for counseling and testing to meet the guidelines and to really do the best patient care that we can to be able to counsel the patients right after a result. So the 20 minutes is very ideal. Additionally, the other good thing about this test is that in many states around the U.S., they're now making this available over the counter for patients to test at home for HIV. I haven't seen that in Tampa per se, but I've seen it in other counties in Florida. And so you may have patients who have gone to CVS, tested themselves, and had a positive test at home for HIV, who are coming in to seek new treatment for a new diagnosis. In that situation, you would, of course, confirm the tests again yourself, then go get the CD4 count, the viral load, and the genotype, just the same as if you had diagnosed them. So just to be aware that this test is very sensitive, very specific, and is starting to be available over the counter for testing for HIV, for home testing. So who should we screen? Well, the newest guidelines, 2012-2013 guidelines from the USPSTF, as well as the CDC and the WHO, they recommend a once-per-lifetime screening ELISA for all adults up to age 70. And that's regardless of any risk factors. However, if they have ongoing risk factors, then they can have more frequent screening, annual screening, or even sometimes more frequently than that, depending on what the risk factors are and how frequently they engage in situations that they can contract HIV. This is especially useful in IV drug users, the LGBT population, and in sex workers.